Build stunning dashboards for the desktop using GrapeCity's FlexChart, a .NET WPF chart control included with ComponentOne WPF Edition. FlexChart boasts over 80 chart types, from common Excel charts to advanced ones like waterfall, box and whisker, histogram, and more. In this video, we will walk through adding the FlexChart control to a WPF application, populating the chart with data, and configuring the chart to best visualize our data. Before proceeding, you may want to watch our other videos, how to download and install ComponentOne, and get started with WPF Edition to learn how to access the controls. Once you are ready, open a WPF application. To add FlexChart, you can first download the NuGet package named c1.wpf.chart. Make sure to download a version equal to or lesser than the version of .NET your application is built upon. For .NET Framework, the package name starts with c1.xaml.wpf. Next, you will find the FlexChart control in your toolbox. Drag it to the design window. By default, you will notice that the chart displays some sample data. This is a design time feature so that you can see what the chart will look like. Take a look at the XAML. You'll notice the chart is composed of any number of series. The series is what represents the data points. Select the control on the design surface. Open the suggested actions menu by clicking the yellow light bulb in the top right corner. You can set common properties like the header, chart type, and color palette from here. We'll come back and configure more of the chart later. Next, we will show how to populate the chart with our business data. FlexChart supports easy data binding through a view model. Consider this business object representing sales data with revenue and costs per day. And our simple view model here returns a list of sales data objects. Keep in mind that FlexChart is designed to visualize pre-formatted data. That means if you need to sort, group, or filter data, that should be done in your code or view model before loading it into the chart control. With the view model set as the data context for this page, we can now bind to it directly on the designer. Like a data grid or a list, you will assign your data collection to the FlexChart's item source property. Open the FlexChart Actions menu once more and select the Binding tab. Locate the item source property, select Create Data Binding, and then select the data object under your view model. You also have to map each field from the business object that you want to plot on the x-axis and y-axis for each series. This is configured through the Binding and Binding X properties. Because our series will share the same x-axis, we can set the Binding X property to date on the FlexChart itself in XAML. Then, for the first series, we will set the Binding and the Series Name properties to Revenue. The Binding property represents what field is plotted along the y-axis. The Series Name is what displays in the legend. Then, repeat the same process for the Costs series. It is important to remove the dummy data and the redundant Binding X property that we already set. We can also remove the third series placeholder completely from the markup, since we only have two value fields that we want to plot. You can also set additional properties for each series, such as setting a different chart type. Here, let's change the Costs series chart type to bar. You can mix and match Cartesian chart types in this manner to create a combined chart. FlexChart also supports stacking series by setting the stacking property. This is best visualized when both series are bar or column. Lastly, in this video, let's see how to customize the axes by moving the y-axis to the right side of the chart and setting the title. Currently, the y-axis is not defined in our markup, so it will be generated using default settings. To define the Y-axis for customization, locate the Axis Y property in the property grid and click New. This will generate the markup for the element in XAML, so now you can more easily set its properties. Here, we can set the title and position, but we could also customize the grid lines, tick marks, and format here. That completes this Getting Started with FlexChart for WPF. For more information, check out the documentation and samples. Thank you for watching, and thank you for choosing GrapeCity.